Greatest hits. One of the true singer-songwriter moments on the record. Wonderful Life's probably another one. While I Can. I wanted the My Story record to have these stripped down moments, just the way that I wrote the songs in the Story House, really. And Greatest Hits was inspired by my inner battle of seeking validation by success in the music industry over the years. Monday mornings would become very important to me, too important. And the reason is Monday morning would be the day you might get a phone call to say that your song is number one. And that's what every singer or songwriter, you aspire to have a number one, because that means that it's reaching more people. But just like in any profession, you can start to kind of put too much weight on the wrong things. And then if you don't get that call, all of a sudden, I'm a failure. If my song's number two, I've failed, my family, I'm a loser. God can't use my song if it's number two, right? And of course, that's such an absurd way of thinking, but sometimes we can fall into absurd ways of thinking because we lean too much on that thing to make us feel like we're enough. And so I would get this feeling, I've been blessed to get that call more times than I deserve. Congratulations, you have the number one song in the country. And I would look forward to it, I would get that call, then I'd hang up the phone, and I didn't feel any different after I got the call. I'd hang up the phone and I'd still feel that feeling. And I found myself praying, God forgive me, why does that matter so much to me? I want to know that I'm enough because I'm your child, not because I've reached any sort of pinnacle on a chart. And so one day I got that call. It was about my song Truth Be Told. And I felt that feeling and I prayed that prayer, God forgive me. And I came back to the Story House and I wrote this song, a song inspired by how it feels to have the number one song in the country. Because I feel like I've spent so much of my time in Nashville trying to have enough hits to where I would make a greatest hits album. And I felt like God was speaking a very life-changing message to me. It's as if he was saying, I'm proud of you, you're working hard, but when you get to heaven, you're gonna find out that what my idea of your greatest hits were in life were way different than what you thought they were. It wasn't one 3-minute song at a time. It's the people whose lives you've impacted, like the ones in your house, your wife, your daughters, your parents, the world around you. Matthew 25, I wrote about it in the God Who Stays book. Matthew 25 is the perfect chapter that really lays out what it looks like to rack up greatest hits in God's eyes, right? I was hungry and you fed me. I was thirsty, you gave me something to drink. I was naked and you clothed me. The idea of when we look beyond ourselves, when we become a character in somebody else's stories, that's when we begin to rack up greatest hits in the eyes of eternity. And so this song was a real personal moment for me. And I wanted to share it with another artist who I felt was on that same track, a country artist named Granger Smith, who I just know and respect. And I sent the song to him. I was like, hey, this seems like a song that would mean something to you. You wanna join me on it? And sure enough, he did. So this is really a special moment on the record that I'm excited to share.